First of all, good morning to all of you. By the grace of great God, the great wife, let us start. Okay, basically, we are discussing the damped harmonic oscillator, and we are reaching at the last segment of this section of this article. See, we have discussed the three cases. We have discussed the three cases. First case is B square is less than, this is case 1. B square is greater than omega naught square. Case 2. B square is less than omega naught square. In the last but not least, case 3 is B square is equal to omega naught square. Okay, what is B? B is equal to R by 2. B is equal to R by 2. And what is R? It means B contains R. What is R? Damping constant. R is called a damping constant. It means this case is called a Hamley damped. So basically, I am just compiling the article. Okay, I am basically summarizing the article in just 2 minutes. This is for the Hamley damped. B square less than omega naught square. What does this mean? Lightning. Okay, shabash. Good. This is not lightning. Lightning damped means damping factor. The dominance of contribution of damping constant is no effective as in the other case. Here damping factor is dominating, but here damping factor is not dominating. It means here we are getting a sustained oscillation. Little bit of sustained oscillation as compared to the Hamley damped. In the Hamley damped, what will happen? The amplitude of the oscillation will immediately die out. But in case of lightly damped oscillator, since the damping constant is not effective, so what will happen? So there will be some sort of sustained oscillations, and the amplitude will not immediately die off. Amplitude of the oscillations will not die off. And the last but not least, B square is equal to omega naught square, it is called a critically damped. Okay, so these are the two graphs for the Hamley damped and for the critically damped. Okay, if you look at the graph, so we can see that the graph is exponentially decreasing for the critically damped as well as for the Hamley damped. But for the lightly damped, what will happen? This is the graph for the lightly damped. So there is a difference. Behavior of these two are almost similar. Are you getting this? The last question that we have written is x is equal to g into e to the power minus bt. Let us take side question number 20. What's the question number 20? See, right, equation 20 is not periodic in nature. हिंदी वालों के लिए बताओ एक बार बेटा, जो पहला केस है इसमें बी है, बी में क्या छिपा हुआ है? बी में आर है. बी में क्या है? आर. बिकॉज डी कैसे बना है? आर बाई टू से. और आर क्या होता है? डैम्पिंग कॉन्स्टेंट. और डैम्पिंग का मतलब क्या होता है? रेजिस्टेंस. डैम्पिंग का मतलब क्या होता है? रेजिस्टेंस. अगर बाहर से ऑपोजिट फोर्स, बेसिकली अगर आर फैक्टर ज्यादा होगा मतलब बी फैक्टर ज्यादा होगा. अगर बी फैक्टर ज्यादा होगा तो हमारी एम्पलीट्यूड ऑफ ऑसिलेशन क्या रहेगी? वो क्या रहेगी? वो सस्टेन नहीं कर पाएंगे. उनके एम्पलीट्यूड क्या हो जाएगा? इमीडिएटली डाई आउट. ठीक है. और सेकंड केस में बी कम है, मतलब आर कम है. आर का मतलब बी कम. अगर बी कम होगा तो हमारा एम्पलीट्यूड ऑफ ऑसिलेशन क्या रहेगा? सस्टेन रहेगा. ठीक है. ये इमीडिएटली डाई आउट हो जाती है, ये इमीडिएटली डाई आउट नहीं होती, ये आफ्टर सम टाइम होती है. ठीक है. ये इक्वल होता है, इसको बोलते हैं क्रिटिकली डैम्प्ड. क्या बोलते हैं? क्रिटिकली डैम्प्ड. और इन दोनों का अगर आप देखिए बेटा, क्या है? ऑलमोस्ट सेम ऑलमोस्ट क्या है सेम ठीक है तो ये भी सेम सी दिस इक्वेशन इज नॉट अ पीरियोडिक इन नेचर बिकॉज़ ये जो फैक्टर है e रे पावर माइनस bt दिस e रे पावर माइनस bt दिस फैक्टर e रे पावर माइनस bt फैक्टर कंट्रीब्यूट्स टू द एक्सपोनेंशियल b कंट्रीब्यूट टू द एक्सपोनेंशियल ओके सी दिस इज फॉर द लाइक क्रिटिकली डैम्प्ड सो दिस इज फॉर दिस इज द एक्सपोनेंशियल b ओके एंड फॉर द क्रिटिकली डैम्प्ड आल्सो देयर इज अ एक्सपोनेंशियल फैक्टर यस
Equation 20
is for this case, critical depth. Okay, equation 20 is valid for the critical depth. And see this this equation 20 is for the critical depth. Critically then, and it contains a e raised to power minus bt factor. E raised to power minus bt means it is an exponential factor. And what kind of what is the nature of the graph? The nature of the graph will be the exponentially decaying. It is exponentially decaying with respect to time. Okay. So please write equation 20. Equation 20 is not periodic in nature because e raised to power minus bt is non periodic. Why it is not periodic? Because this factor is non-periodic. So this system also does not possess oscillations. So this system for critically damped. So this system also does not possess. Also yes. Repeat. So critically damped oscillator, or we can say that critically damped oscillator does not possess oscillations and its behavior is similar to. Heavily damped oscillator as shown in the figure 3. Okay, so I think that is all about for the damped harmonic oscillator. And now non-periodic. So we can say that the behavior of the critical damped oscillator is similar to the behavior of the heavily damped, as shown in this figure. See, behavior is almost similar. It is decaying very fast. Okay, this heavily damped is decaying very fast. See, behavior is almost similar. That's what I am saying. Now we define a new term that is called a logarithmic decrement. First of all, please compile it. Please write it. Did you something? Should I start? Okay. Now we define a new term, logarithmic decrement. Logarithmic decrement. What's the meaning of decrement? Decrement means decrease. Decrement means decrease. Decrement means decrease. Okay. Logarithmic means logarithmic decrement. Okay, that we will take the count of decrement in terms of log. Okay, so please write the definition. Logarithmic decrement of any oscillator is defined as natural logarithmic of the ratio of amplitude of रेशियो ऑफ एम्पलीट्यूड ऑफ टू कंसेक्यूटिव ऑसिलेशंस. रिपीट. लॉगरिथमिक डिक्रीमेंट ऑफ अ डैम्प्ड ऑसिलेटर. लॉगरिथमिक डिक्रीमेंट ऑफ अ डैम्प्ड ऑसिलेटर इज डिफाइंड एज natural logarithmic of ratio of amplitude of two consecutive oscillations. Amplitude of two consecutive oscillations. Okay. Are you getting this? It is basically ratio of the two consecutive amplitudes. It's basically ratio of the two amplitudes. Let us say the first amplitude is. Let us say the first amplitude is R naught, and the very next amplitude is R naught prime. Let us see. This is the amplitude of first oscillation, and this amplitude of the second oscillations, and we have to take a log. So log of this is equal to delta. This delta is called a natural logarithm. Sorry, logarithmic decrement. This delta is called a logarithmic decrement. Okay. Are you getting this? It's a ratio of amplitude of the two consecutive oscillations. समझ आ रहा है? हिंदी वालों को बताऊंगा. मान लीजिए जो पहला एम्पलीट्यूड था वो था आर नॉट. वो क्या था? आर नॉट. जी बात. अगला क्या था? मान लीजिए आर नॉट प्राइम. तो इन दोनों का जो रेशियो होगा उसका लॉग लेंगे, वो किससे इक्वल होगा? लॉगरिथमिक. फॉर द इंटरनेशनल स्टूडेंट्स, सी इट्स अ रेशियो ऑफ द टू कंसेक्यूटिव एम्पलीट्यूड्स. And it is valid only for the lightly damped oscillator. Because for the critically damped and for the heavily damped, what will happen? The behavior is same. It will immediately, the oscillation will, the amplitude of the oscillation will immediately die out. So it is valid for. Lightly damped oscillator. Okay. Lightly. Then, okay, Welshman, Chiteka, okay. So let us calculate the amplitude. Then we will take the ratio, and then we will calculate the delta. Okay. So let us start. I am starting from the omega naught prime. What is omega naught prime for the lightly damped? It's a square root of. Tell me the answer. Just square root of K by M minus R square by whole M square. Okay, so please write. This is the angular frequency of damped lightly damped. This is the angular frequency of the lightly damped. Lightly damped oscillator. Okay, omega naught prime is equal to this one. Let us say T prime is a time period. Of the oscillator. So what's the equation I have? T prime is equal to 2 pi by omega naught prime. Okay. Because in general omega is equal to 2 pi upon T. So T is equal to 2 pi by omega. Okay. So I am using this equation right here, omega naught prime. So use this value. Let us say this is 1, this is 2. Using 1 and 2. So what happens? Samajh aa raha hai? Chiteka, Rabajan Sari. Samajh aa raha hai beta? Rajdeep. Tapaswa. Are you getting this? It's quite simple. Sean, Welshman, if you have any kind of, if you have any query, then you can ask. Okay? See, it's a very simple mathematics. Very simple. Use one into what will happen? T prime is equal to 2 pi by square root of k by m minus r square by 4 m square. Let us say this is question number 3.
I will take the ratio.
I will take the ratio, use this formula, and I will calculate the delta. I will calculate the delta. What is delta? Logarithmic increment. What is the physical meaning of it? It will basically show that how amplitude gets changed. It will basically show that how amplitude gets changed after 1 second. After 1 second. Or I mean to say how amplitude of the oscillations are getting changed. Okay, Chiteka? What is the importance of delta? It basically tells us how the amplitude is getting changed. So please. So let us say R naught prime is equal to A naught which is this power minus B T plus T prime. T plus C prime. Let us say this is question number 4. Solve this. Using 3 and 4 in this equation, delta. Using 3 and 4 in this equation. So delta will be logarithmic of A naught into this power minus BT upon. Also, I will write. Okay. This is the amplitude of oscillations for the first. This is the first amplitude of oscillation. This is the second amplitude of oscillation. Just after 1 second. Just after 1 second. So what I'm getting? What we are getting? Log of R naught A naught into this power minus B T upon A naught into this power minus B T plus B. Any doubt? So it will become log of A naught into this power minus B T upon. See, A naught will get cancelled with A naught. So I will write this power minus B T. This will become this power minus B T into this power minus B T prime. End out. Tapaspa. End out. This will get cancelled. Okay. So, what is delta? Delta will get in 1 log of 1 by e to the power minus of bt prime. And in the denominator, it will become a log of e to the power bt prime. Now, using the log property, which one? Log of m to the power m is equal to n log. Okay. Now, using the log property, log of m is equal to n log n. So bt prime will come bt prime log e. What is log e? Log is equal to 1. Log is equal to 1. So delta is equal to 1. Any doubt? Any doubt? Namaskar. These are quite simple mathematics. Okay. So, what's the value of B? What's the value of B? B is equal to? B is equal to R by 2. B is equal to? R by 2. What about omega naught T prime? T prime is equal to? 2 pi upon square root of K by N minus R square by 4 N square. Using 2. Okay. 2 will get cancelled. So, and now, so it will be delta is equal to 2 pi r by n into a k by n minus r square by 4 n square. This is the logarithm. Okay. And now, you know that r naught is equal to a naught into e super minus pt. Okay, ठीक है, okay. Relaxation time is a time. It's at that time at which amplitude of oscillation will become 1 by e times of its original value, of its original amplitude. Are you getting my point? It is that time at which amplitude of oscillation will become a 1 by e times of the original amplitude or the initial amplitude. What is the initial amplitude? A naught. What is the initial amplitude? A naught. It means when, please write, it is defined as a time during which amplitude of the damped oscillator become 1 by e of its initial value, 1 by e of its initial value, 1 by e of its initial value. Okay, now let us understand. See, when t is equal to tau, tau is the relaxation time. When t is equal to tau, what is the definition? It is that time during which amplitude of the damped oscillator become 1 by e of its initial value. What is the initial value? This a naught is the initial value. It means when t is equal to tau, r naught will be equal to 1 by e of its a naught. Okay? You can write a naught is equal to the initial value. Initial value of amplitude. Okay, Rajiv? When t is equal to tau, r naught is equal to 1 by e of its a naught. What is a naught? A naught is the amplitude of the initial value. Initial value amplitude. What is a naught? It is the initial amplitude. So now use this in this formula. Use this. So r naught become 1 by e of a naught is equal to a naught into e raised to power minus b. T become tau. T become a tau. See, a naught will get cancelled. Okay. 1 by e is equal to e raised to minus b tau. Okay, I can write e raised to minus 1 is equal to e raised to minus b tau. Now compare, what will happen? So you see, powers are same. Compare minus b tau is equal to minus 1 minus 1 is cancelled. So b tau is equal to 1, so tau is equal to 1 by e. Very simple, very very simple. Okay. Okay. What is b? What's the value of b? How much time is left?
5 minutes.
Okay. So b is equal to r by 2. B is equal to r by 2. So tau is equal to 2n by r. Tau is equal to, this is the final expression for the relaxation time. This is the relaxation time. For and for that, it's quite simple. Okay. Now I will define the last one, which is the quality. Please compile it. समझ आ रहा है? बहुत सिंपल आ रहा है। फर्स्ट में डिफाइन दी, फर्स्ट में डिफाइन द ग्राफ, सेकंड में डिफाइन दी लॉगरिथमिक इंक्रीमेंट, दैट इज द नेचुरल लॉगरिथमिक ऑफ दी टू कंसेक्यूटिव एम्पलीट्यूड्स, टू नेगेटिव टू कंसेक्यूटिव एम्पलीट्यूड्स, ठीक है। पहला एम्पलीट्यूड दूसरे एम्पलीट्यूड का क्या है, रेशियो का लॉग, ठीक है। एंड द थर्ड में क्या दिया है, रिलैक्सेशन टाइम, इट इज अ टाइम ड्यूरिंग, इट इज अ टाइम ड्यूरिंग व्हिच द एम्पलीट्यूड ऑफ द ऑसिलेशन विल बिकम 1 बाय ई टाइम ऑफ इट्स ओरिजिनल वैल्यू, इनिशियल वैल्यू। व्हाट इज इनिशियल वैल्यू, ए नॉट, व्हाट इज इनिशियल वैल्यू, ए नॉट, ओके। सो लास्ट कांसेप्ट इज क्वालिटी फैक्टर। Please write quality. Are you ready to count the things? Chiteka, Abaj, Sean, Vashwan, समझ आ रहा है ना? Are you ready? So it's formalized. Q is equal to 2 pi divided by energy at the start of cycle. Divided by loss of energy in one cycle. Loss of energy in one cycle. See, what is the need of it? You have to understand what is the need of the quality factor term. What's the meaning of quality? What's the meaning of quality? Quality means high standard, quality means high standard, good workable condition. Okay, quality factor means we are getting a sustained oscillation. We are getting a sustained oscillations and the energy of the loss will be minimum. Are you getting a point? Quality factor is related to a loss of energy. If the loss of energy is more, then the quality factor will be less. If the loss of energy is less, quality factor will be more, because both are inversely proportional to each other. Okay, lesser is the loss, more is the quality factor. More is the quality factor means more is the amplitude of the oscillations will prevail. Okay, I get my point. Okay, so the ratio of energy at the start of cycle plus loss of energy in one cycle. So how we will calculate the loss of energy in one cycle? Can anybody tell? कैसे निकाल सकते हैं? How we can calculate? Again, we have to calculate the two energy values. And then taking the difference of that. Let us say the first value is E1. Let us say the second value is E2. And the difference of E2 minus E1 will give me a delta E. And that delta is the loss of energy. That delta is the loss of energy in one cycle. Loss of energy in one cycle. So please write. We know that for any oscillator, total energy is proportional to total energy stored at any time t. Is directly proportional to square of the amplitude. Total energy stored at any time t is directly proportional to square of the amplitude. Let us say E is the starting energy. So E is proportional to square of amplitude square. E is proportional to amplitude square. Okay. What's the value of amplitude? The first block. What's the value of amplitude? R naught is the value of the amplitude. R0 is the value of the amplitude. And what's the equation? R0 is equal to A0 into minus B. See, A0 is the initial amplitude and R0 is the amplitude at any time t. See, A0 is amplitude E naught is amplitude and t is equal to 0 and R naught is amplitude at any time. Okay, now you understand the difference. This is the original value, this is the at any point of time. So this is the E is proportional to amplitude square, and what is amplitude? R naught. Please put the formula. E is proportional to R naught square. A is equal to C R naught square. C is any constant. C. What is R naught? R naught is equal to A naught into this power minus B T square. So E is equal to C A naught square. C. A naught square. Thank you for being with us. Please like our channel. This is BGADJ Physics. Thank you so much.